team that's red hot right now is LSU. The Tigers just moved up to number 5 in the country, and they're coming off their best team total of the season. And of course, it helps them to have the conference's top-ranked all-rounder and sophomore sensation, April Burkholder. But no question, you want to win an SEC title, you're going to have to go through the two teams that have set the standard in this conference for more than a decade. For more on that, let's go to my broadcast partner, Lori Strong-Ballard.
Consider this, Jen. Georgia and Alabama have won the last 14 consecutive SEC titles. The dominance is undeniable. They have created a tradition of excellence. Georgia's 16 years will give them an edge in terms of experience. And Chelsea Byrd and her fellow classmates hope their final swan song will result in lucky title number 13 for the Gym Dogs. And if luck is what it takes, well, Georgia certainly has it on their side. In a random draw, they drew what many would consider the best rotation of this competition.
Well, today in the draw, it was very lucky. We sat down and Kinsey picked which package she wanted before any of them were opened, and that was the one that was left at the end for her to choose. So it seemed pretty apropos that we were having some luck to start things out. So I'd have to say this is going to be a pretty lucky year for us.
For an emotional team like Georgia, this kind of luck may be what they need to give them the mental edge to beat the defending SEC champions, Alabama. And for Tide, this season has been about stability. A win at the Super 6 earlier this year set the pace for a phenomenal season. They are healthy and peaking right now. The only glitch in an otherwise perfect season is a loss to Georgia. I'm here now with Alabama head coach Sarah Patterson. And Sarah, you are here to defend the title. But will that loss to Georgia earlier in the season play a mental factor in this competition?
Well, I think if anything, it inspired us. We were ranked number one for several weeks, and the season had been going along so smoothly. And I think if anything, it refocused us and sent us on the sights of the championship season.
In terms of your rotation draw, how does this competition need to play out for Alabama to win?
Well, I think we just have to go out there and hit all four events. We start on bars, beam, and we end on our two strongest events. We're on the bye the last rotation, but that worked out great for us at the Super 6, so we're just going to go out there and do the best job that we can and then see what happens.
And Alabama boasts the defending all-around champion and last year's co-SEC Gymnast of the Year, Gina Rice. Can Gina win another all-around title?
Well, I think Gina's hot, and she's just ready to go. You know, she's been stability for us all year long. I think our athletes look to her. She's warmed up great, and I think she's excited.
Well, good luck tonight, Coach. Jen, all eyes will be on that team title, but an all-around title gives everyone involved a few extra bragging rights.
Absolutely. Thank you, Lori. I think that Gina Rice does have a great shot at going for that second straight all-around title. She is looking to cap off what has been a phenomenal career at Alabama. Here we take a look at some of our all-around competitors for tonight. Erin Dooley for Florida. She's coming off a great all-around performance where she beat the number one and two ranked all-arounders in the nation from UCLA. And there, Lori, you see April Burkholder, the highest ranked gymnast in the SEC right now.
She's ranked third in the country in the all-around, and she is a definite candidate for that SEC Gymnast of the Year, along with Gina Rice.
Well, Laura, you can see these teams are fired up. There's a lot of excitement in the air. They're getting ready to go, and so are we. Stick around. We'll get started as soon as we come back.
You know, Mac, when you gave me the first BC, the first scramble a little bit there, all I remember is you looking over me and saying,
the SEC Gymnastics Championship is about to get underway. The Auburn Tigers will be starting the night out on vault. You see him talking to the judges there, but they have had to deal with some adversity, Lori. One thing, losing Shanna Sumrow, the freshman, earlier this year.
She tore Achilles tendon on this opening pass double pike. You could see it on the takeoff. A heartbreaking season-ending injury for Shanna and a loss on four events for Auburn, but sometimes adversity like this brings out the best in a team.
When we lost Shanna at LSU, we thought, God, you know, that's really going to hurt us. And we've had kids kind of step up and rise to the challenge. And we may even be better now because of that than we were before we lost her.
This has always been a close-knit team, but now they're forced to bond and work together even more.
Absolutely. As Jeff Thompson said, sometimes brings out the best. Senior Christy Boyd up on vault.
Oh, a great vault for Christy. Look at that nailed landing. That vault is scored out of a 10-0, and that's how she wanted to do it.
Oh, Christy very happy with that, and she receives a 9.85 for her efforts. She's the anchor for Auburn in this event, but let me tell you how this meet works. It's a little more confusing than our regular meets. Seven teams, seven rotations. Each team has three byes that they have to get through. We will be crowning a team champion as well as an individual all-around champion. So there's a lot to keep up with, but that's what Lori and I are here for. We're here to help you out. One of the athletes you are going to want to keep an eye on, Ashley Miles for Alabama. She was the one, Lori, who basically won this meet for Alabama last year.
They finished up on floor, and she scored a 9.975 to finish the meet and win the SEC title for Alabama. This is the moment that has motivated this team all year. They said they would do anything to feel this kind of excitement again.
Alabama begins their quest of defending that title on the uneven bars, and here we see sophomore Ashley Miles.
Toe on, toe off. Here comes a release move out of a giant full. It's a Takachev. Very nice height. Straddle back to handstand. Alabama told me they want to pay attention to the details, hitting the handstands and the landings. In an intense, competitive competition like this, that is what's going to win it in the end. Dismount, double layout. She hits the landing. Job well done.
You can see some relief there for Ashley. Very happy with that performance, as she should be. A 9.9 for Ashley Miles on bars. That is a great way for Alabama to get started in this rotation.
Ashley has been so focused and so intense all day during warm-up. Her competition presence is almost intimidating.
Oh, I'd absolutely say intimidating. Meanwhile, Arkansas competing on the balance beam in this rotation. Dana McClellan says there's something she tells herself before every performance.
Well, I say, God still loves you. Get your head out of your butt and put your heart into it.
Hey, whatever it takes. Dana was a little shy to divulge her pre-beam ritual.
Oh, but I'm glad she did. Good words of advice for, I think, almost any competitor.
You notice the towel she just tossed away, wiping the sweat off her hands. Wolf full. Nice job. Good concentration so far. Dana is very disciplined and an even-keeled athlete. Two characteristics that are so key on this event. Tumble series back handspring, layout 2 foot. She's thinking. She knew she was a little bit crooked. She took the step and stayed on.
Very important for Dana to stay on here. Arkansas has already had one fall in this rotation, so they need everybody else to really be on.
This is a tough event to start in this type of a competition. The pressure is high. The nerves can be a little bit shaky. Leap series, switch leap to a wolf jump. Most gymnasts would feel home free right now, heading into the dismount. Just one thing left, but Dana has a big dismount planned here. Tumble series into it, back handspring layout to a full twist. Nice job. A difficult routine.
And just a cool, calm demeanor throughout it. Dana McQuillan gets a 9.8 for Arkansas. Remember, Arkansas is just a second-year program, Lori. Some great gymnastics.
Yes, two tumble series here. Here was the first, back handspring layout 2 foot. The second was into the dismount.
LSU, the fourth team competing in this first rotation. They'll be on floor. And Dee Dee Brough has said that there are some very specific goals that she has set for her team tonight.
I would like to hit the 197 mark. I think that this team is deep enough, and we've been consistent enough throughout this last three-fourths of our season to think that we can, you know, build from a 9.75, 9.8 and get some 9.9s at the end, which will give us that, you know, 197 mark, which I think will help us going into regionals.
Most definitely, all of these teams want to be peaking here at the SECs, but you also have to consider this is the first of three meets in the postseason that will lead up to what everyone wants, a Super Six appearance. So it's all about preparation, continued preparation.
Sophomore Taryn Martin-Jack on floor for the Tigers.
Showing off what LSU does a great job with, and that is their dance and their overall presence and performance on this event. They are wonderful to watch. Front full, front tuck. Her first tumbling pass was back tumbling, and now we see forward tumbling. And my favorite part of the routine, and I think this crowd loves it here as well. There it is, the full package deal, expression, big dance. Take a look at the judges on the sideline. She's smiling. She's enjoying this routine, and that's important. Last tumbling pass. Front layout, front layout. A little bonus there in the final pass. Great job for Taryn. Not huge difficulty. We're going to see some bigger individual elements, but the whole package was there.
And you see it in her score, a 9-9 for Taryn Martin-Jack, the first of what they call a 1-2 punch for LSU on floor.
There we go. Middle pass, front full to a front tuck. Good bonus there as well.
We'll see the second half of that 1-2 punch a little later, but All-American Gina Rice is up.
Fans already getting into it. You hear that Roll Tide?
Large Alabama contingent here. Gina Rice, one of their favorites. And the senior is the anchor for Alabama on bars, and that's a position she says she likes.
I really think I thrive on pressure situations. I think that they put me in that situation because I know how to handle the pressure, or at least I like to think so. So, I like that spot.
A true competitor, and Gina has had plenty high-pressure experience as Alabama's one of their top athletes for 4 years now. Rise to handstand. Half to invert. Very tough grip position there. Half out. Here's her release move. A Takacha. She'll go back down to the low bar. Oh, beautiful handstand position. She is really knocking out every detail, hitting the handstands. It's just the dismount here. Pops it up nice and high, drops into the landing. A great routine.
Well, Gina's the defending SEC champion in this event, and it looks like, Lori, she could probably be in the running here tonight. A 9.95 on bars. What a score for Gina Rice.
Gina has looked relaxed and confident all night. She's had a great warm-up, and that is so important. That really gets the ball rolling, creates a little bit of confidence heading into this competition.
April Burkholder up for LSU on floor. She choreographs her own routines, and you really get to see how creative she is.
You know, what I do when I'm just dancing, just freestyling, doing whatever I do, I think I just use some of that, and whatever comes to mind, basically, when I hear the music, I just feel it, and whatever I feel at that time, I just do it. And I try not to put too much repetition in anything, because I don't like that when people have a lot of repetition, you know, so I just try to keep everything original.
Opening pass, a full in, that's an E-level skill, 2/10 of bonus right off the bat. And you know, Jen, easily this will be the best performed routine of the night. It is so full in terms of dance detail. 2.5 to a front pike. A little bit of a direction problem there. It's hard to tell on camera.
April's just so entertaining, and she uses that in her dance and her choreography. And it, as you said, really one of the most exciting gymnast to watch on floor.
And this routine is non-stop. Talk about endurance required for this. Every detail is choreographed right down to the facial expression. She is non-stop, and here we go for the third and final pass. Front layout, front half, back layout, that's how you do it. Her final salto was higher than the other two. Oh yeah, what a great routine.
Big smile on April's face, and it's hard not to have a smile on your face watching that routine. She's just magnetic, just really captures probably the judges, looks like the judges and the audience as well. A 9.925 for April Burkholder to close out LSU's first rotation.
April matches some of the big difficulty we're going to see in this competition with this opening pass, a full in back out. I mentioned it was an E-level skill.
And there you see the first four scores of the teams that competed in this first rotation. LSU and Alabama both putting up some good scores. And coming up next, it's the Georgia Gymdogs on vault.